Let's now check on the Philippine Stock Exchange's closing numbers. The local bourse back in the red this Tuesday. The PSE's main index shed 0.7%, closing once more at 6,200 level. Value turnover was at 3.9 billion pesos. Stock market investors took profit today after the PSE breached a significant resistance level of 6,300. Lan Soledad of China Bank Securities is on the Business Roadshow to talk stocks and take stock of recent market developments. Good afternoon, Lance.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon. Thanks for having me.
Once again, we breached the 6,300 level. How likely are prices prone to pullbacks now, and how tough is it to hear another or to hit at least another new near-term resistance, maybe 64?
Well, as you mentioned, for today, we just saw a pullback. Our view for this week, considering the market's steep rally over the past month, is that further upticks makes the market susceptible to profit-taking. Right now, we're looking at the immediate support level of 6,150. If we base build at higher levels, the better, of course. But this is what we like to see. We've been suggesting that investors consider accumulating on pullbacks, considering favorable technical conditions that we have right now.
Okay.
We've been seeing much improved trading activity. We're seeing higher volumes on upticks than on downticks. We've been seeing a resurgence in net foreign buying. I think we've been registering net foreign buying for the past, in five sessions, but in the last six. And we also have been seeing favorable news flows over the past month. The positive surprise in local inflation and GDP, the slowdown in U.S. consumer and producer prices. So considering, all the confluence of, those positive factors, we think that accumulation is a good strategy at this point.
Okay, and having said that, the foreigners are coming in again and we're seeing better prices really in the market. Is this now part of that Santa Claus rally or the Christmas rally that we are all anticipating?
Well, hopefully, as I've mentioned, we have the outlook for easing macro headwinds right now, peaking policy rates and continued slowdown in inflation. So hopefully we see this continue through December.
Okay, we're now watching out for oil prices and supply. Now, whatever the outcome of tomorrow's OPEC Plus meeting, which will dictate future directions for global oil prices, how big of a boost did lowering oil prices now have on the market?
Well, we think that it definitely helped support overall market sentiment. Easing global oil prices is helping keep the outlook for a sustained slowdown in inflation intact. And again, as I've mentioned, we've seen a slew of positive news flows over the past month, and decreasing oil prices definitely forms part of those positive developments.
All right. We're really seeing clear winners for this market for this year. You have banking, financials. They've been up a while. Conglomerates also doing good. And now we're seeing an upward trend line for property. And has the outlook changed now for property from your investment house, at least from your point of view?
Yeah, we do believe so. Results across property names have been they've been very encouraging over the past two quarters. We think that it would continue for the balance of the year. If moving forward, if sales take-up continues to be strong early next year, then we think that more aggressive positions in property issues could be warranted.
All right. And of course, the darling of the season would be consumer and retail. Now, if you talk about retail making full return to better top lines, this is it, Christmas season, consumer spending is at an all-time high. Many will revert to frugal mode really after December because hard times are still here. Do you see this as a banner year now for retail? And what percentages, in fact, of profit rises are you seeing in general for the retail sector?
Well, for the fourth quarter, in general, consumer firms remain bullish due to the seasonal uptick in consumption. However, beyond that, we think that consumer firms may see some weakness, mm-hmm. Especially those that have big discretionary products. Since pent-up savings could have been used up already, seeing waning pent-up demand. Apart from that, consumer firms have also started to report that some customers are showing some resistance in being able to accommodate price hikes.
Okay, Lance, let's breeze through some of our big stories today. S&P Global affirming the Philippines' double or triple B plus, in fact, BBB plus rating long-term and A2 for short-term sovereign credit ratings with stable outlook on sustained economic recovery and strong external position. How big a boost do you think this will give to sentiment?
I think this just underscores the country's firm growth prospects. Even during the pandemic, our credit rating has been resilient. Now, post-pandemic, I think this should be resilient, continue to be resilient, and this should, keep market jitters over possible ratings downgrades at bay.
All right. Lastly, Lance, with many investors positioning for next year, perhaps can you give us an idea of the stocks you're monitoring for possible buys in 2024?
For now, as I've mentioned, we've seen a resurgence in that foreign buying. And considering that, you know, we think that prioritizing index names would be a good strategy at this point. For next year, in terms of sectors, we like property, we like REITs. Some property issues that we like include ALI, S&PH, and RLC. For REITs, you know, the likes of C-REIT, M-REIT, ARIT. So we like those names.
All right, Lance Soledad of China Bank Securities, thanks again for being with us and for giving us your market insight. Have a good day.
Thanks for having me. Have a good day.